What's up, guys? There are two questions that I hope to get an answer for from the teardown of this smart Rubik's Cube from Geica. First question, there are magnets inside that creates the auto alignment feature, but where does the clicking sound come from? Second question is how the cube knows the position and orientation of all the pieces, or does it actually? Also as a teaser, I did ultimately tone down the whole thing and I found something unexpected that might interest cubers who have followed these smart cubes. So first off, to break the cube apart, I turn one layer by 45 degrees and wiggle the edge piece off. The rest of the pieces come off very easily afterwards, leaving the 6 center pieces behind. The long screw that keeps the pieces together are removed, and we can immediately see the auto alignment magnets. And there is something very neat that I personally love very much about this design. The magnets actually have a second purpose. The designer deliberately left the magnets loose inside the housing. The magnets are attracted by the ones inside the neighboring piece. It then snaps to the inside wall and conveniently creates a clicking sound. And for each 90 degree turn, we don't just get one but 8 magnets snapping to the walls all at the same time, which gives us quite a nice audio feedback. Now that we have the answer to my first question, let's take a look at the core electronics. The cover of the centerpiece can be pried off. There is undercut in each corner holding it in place. Underneath the blue and the green covers, there is a piece of sheet metal soldered to the PCB. There are in fact the charging terminals that touch the pogo pins on the charging dock and can be desoldered away. The three wires connecting to the board can also be removed. The PCB does not rotate with the centerpiece and is mounted onto the shaft in a bayonet style. To remove it, I first push it in, turn it counterclockwise and then pull it out from the shaft. Under the PCB, there is a copper brush that interacts with the copper padding on the underside of the board. Do you know what's going on here yet? Let's dive a little deeper together. The copper brush has two thinner legs that are always in contact with the inner ring of the PCB. The thicker leg touches just one of the four copper paddings on the outer diameter at any given time. As the disc rotates with the centerpiece, the copper brush connects a certain portion of the circuit together. There are three surface mount resistors on the board. The resistance values are 3.3, 6.8, and 20 kilo ohms. And I also found out with my multimeter that they are connected in series. Depending on the position, the copper brush connects 0 or up to 3 resistors between the two terminals. The resistance values that represent the four positions are therefore a few ohms, 3.3k, 10k, and 30k ohms. And the electronics inside measure the resistance to determine the position. So back to my second question. How does the cube know the position and orientation of all the pieces? Well, it doesn't. But just knowing the orientation of the 6 faces is not enough to determine where all the pieces are. As you can see in this example, the white and the orange faces are turned back to the original direction, but the cube has completely changed. There are simply way more than 4 to the power of 6 combinations in a Rubik's Cube. In fact, there are over 43 quintillion combinations. What the app shows you is only a calculated state of the cube. The electronics inside provides the information to the app, which is which face is rotated, as well as the order of the rotations. And when the electronics fails to provide that information accurately, for example, when it is unable to track rotations because it has run out of battery, then you would get an out of sync cube like I do. Luckily, there's a reset button in the app to fix this. And finally, at the bottom of the shaft, the bottom half of the centerpiece is held by a spring, and that makes the cube more compliant and easier to turn. Now we know what's going on the outside, let's fast forward and take the rest of the pieces off and open up the internal structure. The housings are made of what feels like palm, and the two halves clamp the main PCB in place. There is a buzzer on one side, and a 40mAh lithium-ion battery on the other side. It must have been quite labor intensive to build this up because there are 18 wires soldered onto this PCB alone. And if we look more closely at the PCB, we can see the ultra low power Bluetooth chip. There is also a battery management chip, Bluetooth antenna, and surprisingly, a 3S's accelerometer chip. With the accelerometer, the app should be able to show the orientation of the cube in real time, but this feature is somehow not available. There are some strange things going on here that is beyond my knowledge. And if anyone knows why Geico hasn't turned this feature on, please let us know down in the comment. That's every single component and everything I can tell you about this coupe without boring you to death already. There are in total 183 components packed in this coupe, which is pretty crazy. Please leave a like and consider subscribing if you enjoyed the video. I've torn down other products which you can find in the cart here. I will see you next time.